Well, the official anthem of Saloon Stock Cars is now concluded. This is it, the final race of the night. The Raymond Good Memorial Final for the 2 litre National Saloon Stock Cars. We have 21 on track. Here we go, we are now rolling. Here we go then, the green flag is down, away we go as the Saloon Stock Cars head into battle for their Raymond Good Memorial race. The cars must lap each other before the race even starts. So, looks like a bit of a poor start there for 224, the back of proceedings, I'm afraid to say. Callum Smith, the part owner, is away cleanly in our Saloon Stock Cars Raymond Good race. Everyone is just trying to find themselves a piece of track to play with and hopefully make the piece of track work. So, your leader is going to be Jack Morrinson in the 932 car even, who's had a bit of a rubbish night really. But Andrew Russell is now going to go through and take the lead on the inside, who was reading well earlier on in his respective consolation race before almost getting overturned on the final bend of the race when he climbed the market tyres of the car, thought about going over, then decided not to. Cool, bit of a clash in front, a couple of cars going around. 919 Berry goes charging in the side of a car that was broadside midway around the bend. The 333 lead. Second is 218, then 297, I think, could be in third. No, I stand correct, it's going to be 932 into second, and down to third goes 218. And 218, as we say, has been really well tonight. Oh, where's Alfie Jones going? Goes to exit stage left and turn one. He's turned right, not left, in the end of a shame to win cup cars. Well, Alfie Jones pays a visit to the fence, has survived his experience of fence to tell the tale of it, I'm quite sure. So the question is, can Andrew Russell hold on as Aaron Totten gets delivered a bit of a shot there from 140 afternoons, who rattles him around the plate, I think. Another one staying in prisons for 8th grade, has now managed to get back at full race pace. I thought there was a problem there for Richie Carter, but Carter got going again. And another one goes, and all the lead has been taken out, I'm afraid, to say it's turn two. So Andrew Russell has got his tangled up. But it looked to be the 535 Blinken Black straight, but another one's gone around in a circle and is in reverse. He managed to get out of the way, thankfully. That was James Cotton, went in more in trouble away to our right, but they sort themselves out. Oh, another clash at someone, and Gwendolyn has put away 535 Blinken. Totten goes to the back of Cotton, so Totten on Cotton. You know, you couldn't write it, could you? Oh, back straight, another one goes around, and so Gwendolyn thinks it's gone into the tyres on the far side. Now Callum Smith involved in 224. Now 28 Jack Murray Head deals with the rear end of the car ahead, but not quite as strongly as I think the viewers was expecting him to do so. 14 Alfie Jones now gets assistance from the 333 spin on the fourth bend. The 64 goes around into the bargain, which is a Julian Veyer, manages to rejoin by getting collected by 66 Penderley, who I thought were going to go and deliver the good news, but the good news is kept for another day, I think. Callum Smith is run in, this time by Alfie Jones, but he wasn't part of the room he expected. He just got fired wide and hit the fence very heavily. Two cars rattled around the place, 64 was one of them. The other one was 535 Blinken, the regular Stanlake driver, who raced in the teen sprint form, which is there sort of good for junior bangers, but for a slightly older age group than the ORCI junior bangers many will have known over the years. Spin with home straight, one around the home straight, and Jack Murray had the went in 28 off. What a hit at turn one. Callum Smith is destroyed down there as 333 Russell came into the bend with no control and just sideswiped the car against the fence. They didn't go down their own, there was about three or four more that went with them. And now 327 gets stuck into all the altercations as well of a million down there. But another one's gone around onto the centre, 535 Blinken's only getting a cat and mouse, I think. He seems to have discovered the infield is a much safer place to be than the track. He has got going again though. Right, enough. Your leader is now Blair Gunn in 228. Oh, back straight. Blinken's gone. He's 10 with Sean Smith in 6-1. Berry's gone in. And they get jacked up in turn by Morrison. Oh, that was absolute pandemonium of a moment from the far side. Kazare. And now Smith has decided that the best form of attack is putting him in the fence that comes alongside him. there may be a couple of altercations going on there. Yeah, I think there might be. Oh, big accidents on the far side, two of them in the tyres. Lincoln's one of the fighting bikes ahead on as well from Callum Smith in 334. He goes to turn to green. Now, if you're going to go off, he'd probably give it was a bad job already, Taylor, but he's decided to turn around to go back the right way, like a well-behaved driver would. There's people through Andrew Russell goes up and oh, big clash at turn four. And, well, Morrison has gone. That's taken a couple more into the bargain of James Cotton. And it looks like Sean Smith was on the aggregates for that one as well. Now Cotton's in reverse. He's going to do a nice J-turn, almost. If it wasn't for the tyres, it would have been a good J-turn, but the tyres somewhat got in the way of that one. Anyway, Blair Gunn leads the way. We're on the last five laps anyway in this one. He's run away from the front. We're not really seeing a huge amount of him. Andrew Russell in second place, some distance back, I think, is how I'm going to phrase it after all the crash came up behind. Oscar Berry goes around in front of the leader. Oh, we've got a near rollover. In fact, we are going to have a, not quite, we're going to have a rollover there. James Cotton. Oh, no, we've got a rollover on the extra. Oscar Berry knocks over and goes to for a shot in his roof. What a bizarre incident that was. Now Callum Smith goes in for the kill. Oh, it's carnage up there, someone. And, well, since they came friendly, touch line. Oh, there we go. Well, somebody had to get it for a parked car shot. Eventually, didn't they? So 5-3-5 will probably just win himself a black flag rather than the race. So 2-2-8 of Blair Gunn is your leader. He's taken the change flag whilst all that was going on at turn one, which I'm sure they should all love to see video evidence of. And now I've got someone going opposite as well into the bargain just to conclude the race. Yep, really is going for it. So I think 3-4-9 can be added to the ban list on that one. So the field come through to complete the distance. 2-3 was the winner. The rest of them come through to